Friday and happy 2023. So this is my very, very first Fancy Friday video for 2023. I hope that you all are having an awesome year and I hope that you all are having a wonderful Friday. So first of all, I gotta say hello to my dad and Judy and my best friend Lisa. They are my biggest fans. And then I want to tell you really quick what Fancy Friday is all about, okay? So back in 2020, I was really kind of grieving the fact that I couldn't dress up. And it wasn't that I couldn't, it's just that there wasn't anywhere to dress up to. And then I came to the realization that I could dress up and I didn't need to go anywhere. And so I went into my closet and I found several beautiful formal gowns that still had the tags on them. And I thought, okay, there's a problem here, okay? So I started off just picking a Friday, every Friday, and just dressing up. And I got a tiara, it looked so cute. And then I kind of expanded a bit and thought about, you know, this isn't just about clothes. This is about everything that we consume or that we have in our house, and we have convinced ourselves that there are only certain times to use them. Kind of like when we think about breakfast is for breakfast, lunch is for lunch, and dinner is for dinner. And I know some people have a big thing where they make breakfast for dinner. It's the same type of thing, okay? Ball gowns are for balls, but guess what? They don't have to be. They could be for watching TV or just going to the store or going to the grocery store if you're really brave or for doing videos. We have to kind of get out of that pattern of thinking that certain things are only for certain things or certain people. Okay, so we tend to have fancier things that we only bring out when we have guests. And you've got to start thinking of yourself as a guest as well, and get some use out of those things that you're saving for other people. Do you know how many articles I've read about people who go into their family's attic after somebody has died and there's this silverware or silver or china that was never used? It was never taken out of the box. They didn't even know that their parents, that their family members had it. They were saving it. And what were they saving it for? Because they never used it. Okay? Never used it. I was on a craft board the other day and this person had inherited a bunch of crystal. And she wanted to turn it, use it for crafts because she knew that she wasn't going to use it. It was tons of, I think it was like 40 or 50 pieces. And there was all these people that were like, no, 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 no. Use it for what it's intended for. She was like, but I know that I'm not going to. And they're like, then just give it to somebody else who will. And I was like, if she's going to use it, I just don't see a problem with that. But they were just like, oh, it's beautiful. It can't be used for anything else. I was like, but if she can make use of it, and, you know, she thought of like etching names into it and giving them as gifts, but also maybe etching names in it and using it like a vase. We have to get out of that mentality that, number one, things can only be used for their purpose. And number two, that we have to kind of go into that box of things are for guests, things are for fancy times, etc. No. Okay. So if 2020 taught us anything, it was that we just don't know what's going to happen in the next day, right? We just have no clue, and we are not guaranteed tomorrow. None of us. We have all had losses in the last couple of years, not just 2020, but last year, lots of us had losses, and live it up, okay? Wear that dress that you've been wanting to wear. And wear it, okay? It doesn't matter if you have nowhere to go. Wear it at home or wear it to the grocery store. It's okay. Bring out that absolutely exquisite. Do you need to come in here? It's okay if you do. Well, I'm taping, so if you're in your underwear, you gotta stay over there. Sorry. But that exquisite tablecloth that you enjoy, you love, and it's beautiful, and it seems it's so pretty, but you only bring it out at certain times, and usually that's when guests come. It's okay to bring it out and use it and say, you know what, this is my time that I'm going to enjoy this. Okay, so that's really what Fancy Friday is all about. All right, so to the next part, I started adding an affirmation and a self-care idea to my videos. So now I'm going to talk about them. I have to write them down or I forget. Okay, so the affirmation, this one's a little bit different, but it is this, the perfect moment is this one. Think about that. The perfect moment is this one. We have to stop thinking about the future or the past, and we have to just think about this. So savor that moment that you're in now, okay? And just say, this is it. This is the perfect moment. And the next moment can be the perfect one too, and the next one. But just remember what I said, the next moment is not guaranteed. So savor the moment that you're in, okay? And that is going to be your affirmation. The perfect moment is this one. And your self-care is going to be to connect to a friend, okay? That can be by phone, it can be by email. But find somebody this week that you just want to connect with. It could be somebody that you haven't talked to in ages. It could be your next door neighbor. Sorry, my cat scratching scared me. It could be whatever you want it to be. Like I said, it could be a neighbor that you haven't seen, and it could be a neighbor that you see every day. Maybe you just want to say hi to them in a different way or get to know them a bit better. Just connect with somebody. Just remember that we are made for connection. So just connect with somebody. And if you don't have anybody to call, you can call me. I like to talk on the phone. Okay, so now I want to add something a little bit different because we are in 2023 and we got to add something, right? Okay, so for the first time, I think ever, I have added a word of the year for myself. And that word is declutter. Now, anybody who knows me personally knows that I have a lot of clutter in my house, my brain, severe ADHD. That's just, if you want to ever go into my brain, you'll probably see like all these thoughts just going boom, 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 boom. So the decluttering isn't just about my house, but I am decluttering. I feel like I declutter every day and then somehow it doesn't really seem to make a difference. So I'm trying to just like narrow it down a bit. So I wanted to come up with a declutter idea every week, okay, that you could do if you're interested and kind of do it along with me if you'd like. And I'd love to hear if it's something that you did and what you did. And I just would love to hear from you. If you're watching and you've never told me, I would love to hear from you. So this week, I thought about decluttering your email. Okay, so, but a little bit different. If you spend a lot of time on your phone and going places, you probably get a lot of emails that you're not interested in, and you're probably deleting a lot of emails. And if you've been on email for as long as I have, I keep getting these things, and each day I'm deleting them, and it's like, why am I doing this? I need to streamline things. And so every day I'm trying to go through and just hit unsubscribe. If I'm deleting them and they're coming to me, it's probably on some type of subscription. And some of them are just spam. So mark those as spam so they'll go into your spam folder and you're not getting them every day. So unsubscribe, hit spam. You don't want them. You know, deleting might not be enough. You might have to just hit them and spam so you're not seeing them. But that is going to declutter your life quite a bit because you're not seeing it, you're not dealing with it, and you're going to have more time if you're not just delete, 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 or opening it thinking, what is this kind of thing. So spam or unsubscribe. Some of them just don't have an unsubscribe button or they're a pain. Like I said, just mark spam and they'll eventually go into your spam folder. It might take a couple of days, but all right. So like I said, the perfect moment is this one. Connect with somebody and declutter your email subscriptions and the things that you're getting. And like I said, if you're getting spam, hit spam. Don't just delete. Not going to spam. Mark it as spam. All right. So I hope that you are having an awesome day. And I will see you next Friday. Bye, Daddy. I love you. Bye. It's me again. Remember when I talked about decluttering my brain? I completely forgot to talk about my outfit. I am so sorry. All right, so here it is. Okay, I know you saw it in the introduction. Okay, so you have seen this shirt many times. It's a really good shirt to wear with skirts because it's kind of fitted here. Now, I would normally wear this with a belt, but I can't find my belt. I think one of my kids stole it. Anyway, it would look much better with the belt, but we're just going to pretend that I have a belt. So, also, I just had a screw come out of the tripod, so if my phone drops or something happens, it's because that screw was way more important than I thought. I don't know where that screw came out of. All right. So this is a skirt. I got this for Christmas. It's a very unique pattern. I really like it. It's got a lot of, like, the seam goes like right here and then it goes over here. So it's got a very different type of aesthetic to it, but I do like it. And if I ever go back to work, like in the corporate world, it would be perfect for that too. All right, so that's why this is just tacked on the back. I am so sorry. How embarrassing. Anyway, I'll say bye again. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye, Daddy. I love you. And I'll talk to everybody next Friday. Bye.